I'm just going to record a prologue to the video because I've just realized something. I just had a horrible realization, and it's this button here. So everything I'm about to show you, there's a really good chance it's just going to disappear because I'm going to click this button, which is the new Outlook, because of course all of Microsoft's everything now is going to the cloud. It's all going central, which basically means it's all been written in HTML. It basically means Outlook is a web page, because that's how it can run everywhere, including your iPad and the web and all the rest of it. So let's have a look. I have a strong sense that all of the advanced features I just showed you, that I'm about to show you, are going to disappear. So let's see. This will be fun. I thought I'd do this on camera. Reveal. I mean, look at this for starters. What's this nonsense? This is the email client that you're meant to use to manage multi-billion dollar business. This is the email client that Satya Nadella, who runs Microsoft, uses. Good heavens. Okay, I'm going to fill these in. We'll cut this out because it's not interesting. Setting things up in a jaunty way. Microsoft, respect your privacy. Oh, please. No. Import my settings. So, will this import any of the stuff I'm about to show you? All right. Not interested in customizing my ribbon, thank you. I mean, for one, where have all my options gone? For two. Yeah, I can already tell you this isn't going to work. So everything I'm about to show you is probably a waste of time, to be honest. I cannot imagine that the new Outlook will support any of it. If it does, I've never used it and I don't intend to. Sorry. I think this video is a waste of time, but I'll put it out because I've already recorded it. RIP Outlook and power user features, I think. Welcome to Web 3.7. Hi everyone, this is a quickish video about Outlook, a program I hoped I would never have to open again. I've talked about email in the past. I talk about it in the workbook, and I've, a few of you have seen this screenshot that I'm going to show you how I do this thing. So what I'm going to do is show you how I used to tame Outlook. And I actually used to do this in past jobs. I've been in jobs where I've had many dozens of emails a day, possibly 100, but enough for email to be completely overwhelming if not controlled somehow. I say this in the workbook. This, if you actually do what I'm going to show you, it is not a, it's a considerable effort. The rewards are amazing because now you're the person who's got all the sorted email and you can find anything and you become like the archivist for your project. So it's actually super valuable that somebody does this. In the workbook, I do say that if this is going to be you, you be prepared to spend 10 or 20% of your day doing this. Maybe 20 is high, but it's a lot of time, right? So I'm not necessarily advocating that you do this. this is not recommended necessarily, but if you must manage Outlook, if you are in a position where you get so much email at work, this might help you. So what am I talking about here is, and bear in mind, a lot of this is all test data. Test email data is really hard to do because you've got to make up a bunch of email accounts. So I've kind of fudged this a bit. So some of the features don't work exactly right. So I'll explain why that is when we get to it. So here is the scenario. Here is your inbox, right? We've got a whole bunch of email and I don't have conversations turned on, but I can turn that on, but you can still get the idea. You should always have conversations turned on. So at least things thread, like that's a thread, and that helps, but it's still not amazing. So what can I do for you? I can do this for you. Have a look at this. And this is the screenshot that you've seen. So what I used to do was, the Johnny Decimal numbers here are completely made up and they make a little bit of sense, but we're not going to talk about them at all. They are not the point. The point is, have a look at this. I've got this thing where every email thread is in a decimal folder, which is the folder for the piece of work to do with that thread. Because when you're at work, every specific task, every job, down to a reasonably granular level, should have a Johnny.Decimal ID. The first trick is, basically, there's actually nothing clever about the first part, which is just that you have to put everything in folders, right? So here they all are. Again, don't pay any heed to the actual numbers. They're all just for examples. But here are all those emails just in folders, all right? So that's the first part, and that's nothing clever. You've got to get your emails into these folders. So we'll come on to how you get them there in a second. Now, how do you display this unified view of them all? Well, that is, you use a search folder, and your search folder needs to be just a simple unread mail folder, and that is all unread mail in your inbox. And the key with that is it will cascade, and let's just check the rules on that. Been a long time since I did this. Oh, there aren't even any criteria. You need to have subfolders on. So you want to do your inbox and search subfolders. Second thing is, the key is just a view. So the view, and you basically group by, this can be really weird and finicky, and I've, like, mine's set up here and it works, but you can see when I go to my view settings, group by isn't actually grouped by anything. It's a bit weird. I think maybe because here I've already ranged by folder, maybe that's why. Once you've got your view setting set up, it doesn't change. So as long as you can tease it into this, the other way I think I can do is in folder, it's called. You've got to do, if you do it this way, you've got to do group items by, you've got to select available fields from all mail fields, and then in folder will appear as one of these. There we go. Group items by in folder ascending. Okay, that will achieve the same result. But it's probably quicker. I think this might be new, but that's the same thing. That is it. So that's that view. Simple as that. Now what I do in this view, often with a keyboard because the arrow keys work there, that's nice. I work in this view. Do not work in your inbox because your inbox still has all this stuff in it. This is your view to work in. It's the only place you work. Because then you can decide, and the beauty is you can decide by category, you can decide by area, you can decide by whatever you know is important at the moment. It's also, by the way, you can easily see the things that are unimportant and just choose to ignore them. So for example, what I've done, and I recommend this, I create a category for just notifications. I sometimes call it spam. All the stuff you're going to get because you've just got a job, but you don't necessarily care about it. You want it there for later. By the way, you can add that to your favorites. It's here. ServiceNow notifications, right? Notifications from the system. Yeah, great, fine. Don't need to see them. That's Control Q, marks as red. Learn the shortcuts. SharePoint, what's this? Some notification. Nonsense. Mark as red, right? And that will disappear. So that's the first trick. Second trick is how to get these things into folders in the first place. Well, that is where your friend is. I'm just going to do this. Let's just send an email to test@testydecimal, subject is whatever. All right, so that's gonna go. Okay, mail's arrived. There you go, here's this new mail. First time around, your trick is with the first time that you get involved in a conversation, the trick is to move it. Oh, thanks Outlook. The option goes off the bottom of where I've got the window here. That is intensely annoying. Two options down from here, there's nothing I can do about that. You can see in your own Outlook is always move messages in this conversation. So move, always move messages in this conversation. You click that and it says, where do you want to always move these messages to? And then you choose one of your folders. I'll choose that one. That gets moved there. And future messages in this conversation will go there. I've got an example of this already set up. I've teased because, again, all of these are just coming from a single email address because of me, the way that I'm setting up these tests. So you can ignore this. So let's send a response. What are we in? App 25B review session. App 25B. There we go. So Ralph has written back to me. Ralph has said this, and I'm going to write back to Ralph and say, that's terrific. Ralph, thanks very much. We're going to send that. And the beauty now, let's mark a bunch of these as red because we have dealt with this conversation. That's the other nice thing is these will just go from, so 25B has disappeared from that view now because there's nothing unread there until that new email's come in. There it is. And it goes into the folder because of the thing where you do right click and you move and you always move Ah, there you go. That's where that thing would be. But we've now got disable always move because it's turned on. You get the idea. You're going to have to be really proficient at Outlook if you're going to do this. So all of this should be very familiar to you. I think that is it. That's the main trick. Unread mail, group them by. Oh, of course, rules. Sorry. Things like ServiceNow. I've just got a rule that says, because these are always going to be new conversations, right? These are system notifications, but you can just set a rule from the sender. And I find it useful when a bunch of stuff does come into my inbox, do it in stages, process your inbox, move things into folders, do not deal with them yet, do not reply to them, put them in folders, and then use this view to choose when to reply to them. There is a setting to put what you want to do. I won't look through all the settings now. Oh, here we go. When replying to a message, there, turn that on. When replying to a message that is not in the inbox, save the reply in the same folder. So now, when I reply to Abby and say, you're the best, that message is in this folder. It's not in my sent messages, because sent messages is a waste of time. This is all chaos, right? What I want is for everything to do with app25b to be in the folder. And there it is. There's that message that I just sent. That'll do. That's the most of it. If there's anything else you want to know, let me know. It's been a while since I've done this because I don't use Outlook at work anymore. Yay. But if I can help at all, just let me know. Thanks and good luck. And I'm not recommending this, but if you have to do Outlook, it can really help. All right. Good luck. Thanks. Bye.